Hello. Hello. Tiago, Naveen.
Hi, Snail. Yes, sir.
See, last class I explained about collection. See, basically what happened is this is my student where I have name, mark, grade. Okay. There I provided my initial values. What happened? I took the loop, which is called multiple records looping. Okay, in that loop, I selected my collection. I just processed with the data. Okay, so see here. It is taking the record from the loop and started processing the loop. See here, it is changing. Now, if you go to the grade, you see the current value, everything is updated. Initial value is nothing, whereas current value, after processing that, you got the grade and all. Okay, so this is the one program. Do you have any doubts in this? Did you all got the video and you guys started practice so far? Hello?
Yes.
Okay, can I go and create a small program in similar way? This is my Excel. Today I'm going to talk about only this topic. This is my Excel, okay? And it is stored in the Excel. The data, whatever, instead of collection, I put it in an Excel. Now I want to read this Excel. Okay, so what I'm going to do is when I open an Excel in the task manager, you see the Excel instance is created, which is the Excel instance. If you go and see here, Excel 32, when you end the process, Excel will be go away. Are you got my point? Now I'm going to create a session to create an Excel. So just create a process. Okay, simply online batch. Underscore Excel operation. Next, finish. Double click on the process studio.
Hi, sir. Before going to that, I have one doubt. Sorry for interrupting.
Yeah, tell me.
Yeah, can we have like multiple collections and use only one loop for that?
Multiple collections in the sense? What it means?
There will be cases we can have multiple, one or more collections, right? Can we have? Can we use the same loop for all the collections? So, for example, you did. One example, right, for grades, getting like the calculate the grade for the students, right? So
yeah, you
for
can it. You see multiple collections for processing, it won't get it right. You will take one record and you have to process it in Blue Prism. You should not take a multiple records in different collections. See, it is basically a repetitive job only doing for RPA. Okay, you are not going to do any manipulation. It's highly impossible. Routine jobs only you are going to do, right?
Okay.
Am I right or wrong?
Yes, yes.
Okay, so in that case, why do we need a multiple collection? Puridhingla?
Yeah, but this job.
Sandeep came and left.
Hey, Naveen, this is Sindhil here.
Yeah, what happened?
No, actually, due to internet connection problem, I am not able to log.
See, first one is I will take an action. Action is something like to call the VPO. Okay, the VPOs are classified into two types. One is, let me take online notes one. Object Studio. This studio is used to define a specified process. Or you got my point? Or you can say defined a custom process where I want to do my customization. So example, interacting with Excel. Okay, email trigger, email component. Interacting with email component. Another one is database or automating window application or automating web application. Another one is automating mainframe application, mainframe terminals. Automating mainframe terminals. Okay, so basically these are all the information which you can do customization. Am I right or wrong? In that Object Studio, the Blue Prism is providing few customization that is called as VPO, which they are call it as Visual Business Objects. It should not be a business visual basic object. It is a visual business objects. Got my point? VBOs are classified into visual business object abbreviation. They are classified into two types. One is predefined VBO. Predefined VBO. Another one is user defined VBO. One is predefined VBO. Another one is custom defined VPO or user defined VPO. When you come into predefined VPO, all my Excel interaction, Excel, another one is database, communicating to database, another one is email component, like etc. So like that, anything related to the standard things which will be a Blue Prism already provide for us. For example, I will show you here. Before going to talk about the process, just go to your business in the file. See here, right side top left, import, choose browse file. See here, anything related to the calendar, anything related to OLEDB, that means anything related to MS SQL Server or anything, we can use OLEDB provider. SQL Server, email, Excel, Word, Active Directory, any manipulation related to collection, date and time manipulation, encryption, environment, file management. So all these things will be interacted with using these VBOs. Am I right or wrong? So the very first VBO which I am using is MS Excel. Already I had imported in my process. I will show you. See here, MS Excel VBO. Do you guys have any issues? These are all the actions which we are having. Initialize, clean up, remove, blank, check instance, create instance, check file exists. Everything you can check. All these things we can have related to Excel operation. This, they are already defined. It's also like a similar structure only. Check file exists, come start. Then I will have, they will have a code whether the file is exist or not. See. Whatever the file name you are passing, just go and check that boolean flag and it will return you as an output. Or you got my point? So all these things will be defined in this parameter. Now what I am going to do, I am going to use that in my Blue Prism. In the action, I just say create Excel instance. Create Excel instance. Okay, in the business object, I just go and select MS Excel BBO and try to create an instance. Create instance of an Excel. In the output, just I'm storing a number. 1 hour we create an instance, it will store a number. There are two numbers will be there. Just click OK. See here. Excel instance is created or not? Let me show you. See, instance is created. Now go to here. Nothing will be there. Only the instance is created in the background. Are you got my point? Guys, you got my point? Hello?
No, sir. It's come again. Can you explain me again?
See, whenever you open an Excel, what will happen? Under Task Manager, there will be an Excel instance process will be created. Am I right or wrong? Do you see in that Windows Task Manager anywhere? Have you seen it? Hello?
No, sir.
See, whenever you open any program, what happens? Whenever you create any program, there will be a process which under which the Excel instance will be created. Am I right or wrong? So this will be run in the RAM. This particular information will be stored in the RAM. So whenever you open, see here, there are applications will be there. This is called Windows Task Manager. How many applications are running currently, we can visualize. Am I right or wrong? So to create that Excel, first you have to create a process. For that, in the Blue Prism, there is an Excel BBO which has a create instance. Are you got my point? In the create instance, I'm having an handle. So now what happened, when I refresh and try to create that, the Excel instance will be created. So when you go here, you can't see the application because you are not opened the application, but in the process you can see an Excel instance. Am I right or wrong?
Yes, sir.
Are you got my point now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now what happened? I'm just going to kill that instance. Now what happened? I'm going to delete this. I'm taking another action. Okay, here, create workbook. In this create workbook, just to go MS Excel BBO, there you can have create workbook. Are you got my point? In this create workbook, you are passing which instance you have to create a workbook. I will show you what is workbook. See, generally you open an Excel. This is my Excel workbook. If you close it, this is called Excel instance. This doesn't have any Excel sheets. We call it as Excel workbook. In that, if you open our new blank workbook, what happened? A workbook will be created. This is called workbook. The one which will show you, right? The workbook. This workbook will be opened, and that workbook, these are all called as worksheets. The sheet 1, sheet 2, sheet 3 will be called as worksheets. Are you got my point? So you have to predominantly understand what is workbook and what is worksheet. See, this is your instance. Excel instance is this. Okay, in this Excel instance, you are creating a workbook. In that workbook, there are sheets. So coming to the Blue Prism, I am trying to create my instance. Under this instance, before I created an instance, I am saying that this is my instance. In the output, I want to store my workbook name. Or you got my point? Just go to input, this is my handle, and creating a workbook. Click OK. After creating the workbook, I want to show the workbook. So I'm simply say show workbook. Just go to MS Excel BBO. This is my business object. In that, you will have a concept called show. That you are going to provide which instance of Excel has to be shown. Just go and provide the handle. Output, you no need to have anything. Just try to link it. Refresh, run. See here, you got a two worksheets. It has created its own name. See here, the number which you are seeing here is, this is called a work instance name, under which it has created a two sheets, three sheets. Am I right or wrong? Now go to task manager, you will have two Excels, which is created by Blue Prism, which is an ordinary process. Now go for, see here, there are two Excel instances is created. Now you got my point? Hello, guys, are you there? Nagashiva, Dinesh, Vengadesh, yes, you all understand?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. Sir. Now I am trying to close the workbook and I am close the work, this worksheet. Now here, if you look into that, I don't want to create a workbook. I want to open a workbook because already I had a workbook. See, this is my workbook. Okay, so I want to open a workbook. So what I can do is, instead of create, I just go down. I can simply say open workbook. Now I'm not creating the workbook, I'm opening a workbook. In that, I want to provide my file name. How to provide the file name? Just control shift, right click the file where you can have copy as path. See, normally when you right click, you won't get that particular copy as path. What you have to do is shortcut key control shift where you can copy as path. Now go back to the Blue Prism. Just paste. The Excel entire path will be to get entire path of a file. Press Control plus Shift plus right click. Okay, in that you get copy as path menu. Copy as path menu. Right, so when you done this, what will happen? You can copy the path of the file. Like, see here, control shift, right click, copy as path. Now try to paste it here. Path has been stored in a double quotes. Now go back to the Blue Prism. Workbook name is created. The whatever the value you will having, you are having to store in a workbook name. Just click OK. Try to reset, run. See that the workbook will be get opened. Now go and see the workbook. See? The workbook which I tried to open is opened or not? Any doubt in this? Any doubts? Okay. Now, after open the workbook, I want to identify my worksheet. So what I can do is, I can delete this. I can move this here. So let me take an action, right click, open worksheet, just go Excel VBO and go worksheet. Open worksheet will be there. Okay, right collection. Read data to collection. Read data to collection. What you will do is, you, what is your number? Handle it. Your workbook name. And what is your collection name you have to provide? Student data, and just click student data. Okay, just drag and drop. The student data collection comes here. Worksheet name. The sheet name is already in this Excel. This is your sheet name. Output is your sheet name. Just copy this, go back, paste it in the double quotes. Now you can say from which cell it has to read. I can simply say A1. Why I am providing A1, I will show you. So this is my A, this is my B column, this is my B, C column. In that, the row one, I want to start reading the text. So that's why A1. See here. If it comes here, B1. If it comes here, C1. If it comes here, A2, B2, C2. So like that, it will start reading. So I'm telling that A1 and just make it as true. Sorry, read collection. Why it is writing? Get worksheet as collection. Handle workbook name, output sheet. Just go here. You try to call the collection data here. Just click OK. Purida Purilia. Are you guys with me or not? Hello?
புரியல சார்.
ஓகே ஃபைன். சி ஐ ஹட் ஓபன் மை ஒர்க் புக். ஐ அம் ரைட் ஆர் ரங்? ஐ ஹட் ஷோன் மை ஒர்க் புக். ஆஃப்டர் ஷோயிங் தட் ஐ வாண்ட் டு ரீட் டேட்டா டு த கலெக்ஷன் டு ப்ராசஸ் ஐ வாண்ட் டு கெட் த டேட்டா இன் த எக்ஸல். ஸோ வாட் ஐ எம் கோயிங் டு டூ இஸ் ஐ வில் ஹாவ் அன் ஆக்ஷன். ஓகே, ஐ வில் ஹாவ் அன் ஆக்ஷன் where I can say read data from Excel. Okay, so when I try to read data from Excel, I just go and say MS Excel VBO. There I'm going to say that get worksheet as collection. Just go number, handle it. What is my workbook name? This is my workbook name. What is my worksheet name? Output sheet. Am I right or wrong? Till now you understand this?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now once I read that, that data should be stored in a collection. Am I right or wrong? Because this is a collection data. Am I right or wrong?
Yes, sir.
This is a collection or not? So now I'm going to say that student data is my collection. I'm just, once I write this, I just click on this. What it is saying, click here to automatically create a data item of required type. Click, see that collection is created. Am I right or wrong? Just click.
Yes, okay. Sir.
Now coming back, this empty. Double click, you have to create a field. How to create a field is, what is there in the column name of this? What is handle? It is basically instance ID. name, number, or you can provide the text as text. Then click add field. See, I don't want to do right now. I can show you why I am doing this. Okay. Now what
sir, sir, actually you are opening a worksheet which has been created before.
Yes. Yes.
So then what is the need for doing action like create Excel sheet, create a book?
See, I am automating. I am actually automating. See, as a user, when you double click it, Excel is opening. If I want to automate and create an automation with the help of Excel, what should I do? It has to create on its own, right?
Yes, sir.
So that is what I am doing. See, it is creating an instance, it is creating a workbook, it is showing the workbook, it is reading the data. I am not going to do anything on that. Okay.
Okay. Sir, the action showing the workbook means whether it will show only the data or it will also it will create the Excel instance and workbook and then it will show the data.
No. See, show means displaying the workbook. Otherwise, if I remove the show, this Excel will run in a background. You cannot able to visualize.
Sorry, but show the workbook means already created on the Excel sheets la create adhula thana sir and workbook irukku and the data sir so automatically adu varumla sir
varadhu background show workbook endradhu background la open ah irukum but adu neenga display kondu varana end user ku appadina you have to use show workbook illa na and the workbook pinnadi background la run ah irukum
okay sir
okay
Okay, sir. Thank you.
I think someone is Nagashiva. 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 Not speaking. Okay. So after reading the data, once the show workbook is completed, it is reading data from Excel, then just run. See here. Data is readed from the Excel or not? Whatever the data which are available in the Excel, it is readed or not? Guys?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so now if you see here, the mark is text. Actually, it is a number. Am I right or wrong?
Yes, sir.
It should not be a text. So yes. To define that, what I can do is I can manually configure the data types of the field. So just to go open this Excel, copy the name, should be same as in this here. So copy this text. And you can provide name of the student. Then create add. Just go. Copy this marks. Number. Mark of the student. Add field. Grades of the student. Okay, now run. See, it is a number data type or not? Name, text, number data type. Are you got my point? So all these things will be there. Now what happened? As usual, you are going to loop it. Delete. Refresh. fatal loop. Double click. Student data. Student manipulation. Student loop. Just click OK. I'm bringing here. Okay, there I can take a choice. Double click on the choice. Simply say grade A. I can simply say marks, which I does this yesterday last week. Just go here, create an expression of logic and click on that logic. Go here, less than equal to, go to collection, student data, marks, 100, paste. Okay, now click, go to logic, greater than, under collection, marks, make it as 90, paste. Okay, paste this, the logic has been built. Then place. Guys, can you go for a Shiva?
Yes, yes. Could you hear me?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Shiva, are you understanding? Hello? Shiva, are you understanding?
Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Okay. Carry on.
Can you go for a mute? Tiago and Shiva?
Sorry. Hello.
Yeah, yeah. Grade B. Just click. Go to logic and again click on numbers logic. Simply say logic is less than equal to marks 90, paste. Just go here under logic, greater than marks 75, paste. Okay, paste. Okay, this is grade B. Now add. You can say grade C. Okay. Now build a logic. Number. And operator. Click this. Logic. Less than equal to. Collection. Marks. 75. Paste. Okay, click logic. Logic greater than equal to marks 60, paste. Click okay, paste this. Okay, now after completing this logic builder, just click okay. See, the logic is builded. Now what you have to do is you have a calculation part. You can simply grade A. There you can provide grade A and store it in a collection of this variable student.grades. Click OK. Same way, take a calculation. Double click grade B. Provide the expression as grade B. Okay, now I'm going to store back into the collection of marks grade B. Okay, again I'm trying to copy that grade. Just take a calculation one more. double click, I can say grade C. I can provide the expression data is grade C, need to store in a variable student.grades. Just click OK. Just move here. And finally, otherwise, calculation. Double click, no grade. You can simply say here, grade not applicable. And store it in a collection of grades. Okay. Now try to link in between these things. Just click on a link from the read data to loop. From there, it is coming here. Try to link this, link this, link this, link this, link to the student loop end. And try to loop it. Now refresh. See how it is working. Open a workbook, show the workbook, read the data, loop starts. Oh, sorry. I took it as mark, so that is why. See here, I have a initial values, nothing is there in the current value. See, the data is updated or not, guys?
Yes, sir.
File is processed, yes, sir. Or not? File is processed or not?
Yes, sir.
So Wednesday, what I'm going to do, whatever the actual process, we are going to store it back to the Excel. You got the collection, right? In that collection, I want to write it back to Excel. See here, I can show you one more beauty. See, I am removing this from the workbook, open workbook. I'm directly linking read data from Excel. I'm not showing that. I'm not showing the workbook in the taskbar. See here. Right click, show desktop. Right click, task manager. See, there was no Excel instance. Now what I'm trying to do is run. Workbook is open, directly reading the data. It is not showing the workbook in the task manager, but the data is working fine. And to understand the show workbook is, if you want to display the Excel to the end user, you can display it. If not, you no need to have a show workbook. Everything will run in a background. See here, the Excel is open. Have you got my point? Now, if you refresh, see the Excel gone. It will automatically kill the memory. Have you got my point? Hello? Guys, are you able to understand?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Because if you respond only, I can see whether you are understanding or not. Okay, don't make me mistake. See, the point what I am trying to explain here is, see, this is my Windows application. Okay, when I'm double click on it, what will happen in the task manager? Windows application CAL is open or not?
Yes, sir.
Okay, if I close this, it will go on out of it. Again, when you open it, the application CALSIS comes in. So what happened is, as per the real-time or programming language, whatever you are trying to open in the task manager, it will treat it as a process. Everything will be treated as a process. And each process will consume certain memory in the RAM. Are you got my point? When I say memory, it is in the RAM. Do you remember when I explained the data type?
Yes, sir.
I think some disturbance. Who is that dog's disturbance? Hello? Okay. So, and one more thing is, there is a memory will be allocated to that particular each application. What is the number of memory, KB of memory it is consuming? That will be shown here. I got my point. So when you open any application, if I open this, it also has a memory. Zoom, if you go here, Zoom IDXE. See here, it consumes some memory. So like that only it will works. Okay, so here, when I try to open an Excel, a memory will be consumed. See here. If you go and see your task manager, Excel 32 is created. Because you from the Excel, you are reading the value, right? For that, it is creating an instance. Now, when you reset, what happened? That will go on away from the RAM because you are resetting the entire Excel instance and application programming. So this is called working with Excel concept to read the data and start processing it. Do you have any doubts, guys? Anybody has a doubt?
Sir, what if I handle and the create panna enna sir agum? And the create Excel and the idukapra.
See, inga pathinga see, this create Excel instance means without creating an instance of an object, I cannot able to open the Excel. See, you want to open any component, what you will do, you have to open that, right? You have to create it, right? Hello?
Hello. Yes, sir.
Kekuda?
Kekuda? Kekuda, sir.
What is the purpose of main method in C or C++? Can you guys tell me? It is an entry point of an application. Am I right or wrong? Any application, the entry point is main method. Am I right? Hello? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Okay, so similar way, to create an entry point of Excel without creating an instance, I cannot able to work with that Excel. That means I am trying to create a Excel VBO instance. Let me show you. Create instance. Double click on this. There is a code. Create object.excel.application. It is a VB code which they written inside. Are you got my point? So without that handle, they cannot able to do anything.
Okay.
Are you got my point?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So without creating an object of that particular EXE, it is an executable file. Excel.application is an executable file which is there in the Windows 32 folder. To enable that, you have to call this particular create instance. If the Blue Prism is not providing that, we manually try to write these three lines of code. What Blue Prism does is, it is automatically created for you. Okay. Now you got my point?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so here, once they created an instance, they are enabling the events. If you go here in the condition, nothing is there. Output, nothing is there. Only just they are putting enable events. Okay, so once you they enabled it, you can provide get the handle. Puriyudhingla? Hello.
Puriyud sir.
Okay, so that is how it works. So now, once I try to create an instance, just what I will do, I will call my Excel VBO and create an instance. Once I create an instance, it will return me an output of handle.
Okay.
That handle I am capturing and storing in a number. Okay, after that, in that instance, I am trying to create open a workbook. In that open workbook, in Excel VBO, I am saying that my input is, this is my handle. In this instance, this is my workbook you have to open. This is an Excel workbook, okay?
Yes, sir.
So I want to open this workbook in that instance. So that's what I'm saying here. Under this instance, this is my workbook need to be open. Okay. So what happened immediately output, it will provide me the workbook name after opening it.
Okay.
Once the workbook is opened, I'm saying that read data from the workbook. That's what I'm saying. Get worksheet as a collection. I'm saying that under this instance, under this workbook, this is my sheet. Try to read the data and give it to me. Okay. Just a second.
Okay.
Sir, audio is not here.
I'm sorry. I'm speaking to my. I got a call. I'm sorry. Okay. Hello.
Hello. Okay, sir. Okay, sir.
Okay, fine. See, after that, what happened? I'm providing my output sheet, and my output is the collection. Whatever the data it is providing, the data I'm storing it in a collection. Have you got my point? That's what I'm saying. Student data. In the collection student data, I create a marks. Earlier, when I'm not created these columns, what will happen? Automatically, it will take it as a text. Okay, so to enable that, what should I do is, I go here, I am specifying the data type with the name. Okay? Then initial values is null. It automatically read the data, put it in this collection. From the collection, you know how to do the logic. It's very simple thing. No need to worry much. Create an instance. Under that instance, open a workbook.
Open.
Under that workbook, start reading the data, putting in a collection. Whereas, the previous program, what I done is, I just read the data. I just created a collection manually and put the data. Instead, I'm reading from the Excel dynamically. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Any doubt please so far?
No, sir.
Okay, guys. We can meet on Wednesday to... What we can do is, in the Wednesday, whatever the loop we done, the manipulation we done, we have to write it back to the Excel. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Okay, guys. Have a great day.
Thank you. Thank you.
Nagar Shiva?
Sir.
Can you contact
Hello?
Can you contact me after this call?
Yeah, I will be contact. Yes, yes. I'm able to close.